Next, the global headquarters for pharmaceutical giant AstraZeneca will be built in Cambridge. Final approval has been granted for the site, which includes plans for a research and development centre. Now, it is a big investment, costing £330 million. 2,500 staff will be working there, and it's due to open at the end of next year. However, the move has angered protesters, as animal research will be conducted at the facility.
The chamber echoed with anger and vitriol as AstraZeneca staff and Cambridge City councillors left this morning's meeting. Animal rights protesters were devastated after full planning permission was granted for the medical research giant to build its global headquarters on the Addenbrooke site.
But as the planning committee goes, we have to deal with the research and development sort of facilities as, you know, in terms of what they are in principle, not in necessarily in terms of the more detailed use that some expect to be the case.
Some work has already started on the 60,000 square metre site. AstraZeneca says there will be a small animal testing facility using rodents to support its cancer research programmes. But campaigners say they will continue to fight today's decision.
I feel very upset that this application has been approved, despite the fact there has been absolute legal basis for this application to be refused.
Animal research plays a small but vital role in the development of nearly all the medical and veterinary treatments that we know today. And this isn't cosmetics, that's been illegal in the UK for over a decade. What we're talking about is critical medical and veterinary research in the UK.
For many, though, this company will be a welcome addition to Cambridge, another push towards making it the scientific epicentre of Europe. 2,000 staff will work here, their research world-leading, dementia, diabetes, cancer, cardiovascular disease. Many people have already relocated, a phased approach to minimise impact on local schools, housing and roads.
Many of our people are coming to the area, finding schools, finding houses. We're also able to attract people internationally from Europe, the US and around the world. Yes, it's getting busy. Yes, there's some congestion that we have to deal with. But I think there's an infrastructure plan to build Cambridge that will enable it to continue to grow.
AstraZeneca said it was pleased with today's news. Anna Todd, BBC Look East.